mouth is oddly watering right now.
They're good. And this is the best kind. I've tried them all. Roland is the best.
I'll let you do
like some are really mushy.
I'll let you do the honors.
It's so good. It's an excellent source of omega 3s.
Bon appetit.
What are you gonna do? You got questions?
Kind of. Alright, my name is Jose Jimenez.
Hey, good. Let me get this out of the way.
My name is Jose Jimenez, and I'm here with Brett Whitacre. We're actually at his studio today. We're gonna do a little studio visit and tour. But before we get to that, I'd like to, just ask you how you're doing today, man.
I'm doing alright. I'm, catching my consciousness again. I've been in the fumes for a while. But, yeah.
Yeah, we caught you.
I'm pumping it up. I'm doing my third piece today, painted.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Is that for a specific show? What's going on?
Yeah, I'm finishing up three pieces that are already almost finished. That needed little touches done on. I'm hanging a show tomorrow in Chicago at District Furniture on the north side, 4835 North Damon. And I'm having a solo show with an opening this Thursday. My phone's talking to me. Tomorrow I'm loading all this stuff into the van and taking it there to hang it and see what sticks.
Just a little background story. How'd you get started with your paintings, like your style?
Just kind of accidentally just started experimenting. I didn't set out to do art or be an artist. I always did little things for myself. But one summer while living in Chicago, I started, I'd always like collected junk from the alleys, you know, carry home some windows and find used windows chucked in the trash, old TV sets, suicases, like hard shell suicases, just lining the alleyways, and I always liked to walk the alleyways. And I'd find, if I'd find something interesting, I'd bring it home and illustrate something on it, or paint something on it, put some stripes on it, or whatever, just for myself. And one summer, an artist friend who actually went to school for art and had a degree, he saw a couple things that I'd created and said, "Hey man, you should do more of those." Mm-hmm. And that's when I was like, "Oh yeah, maybe I should," you know, because I was working a couple hours in the day and came home and was doing nothing until band practice, so. Mm-hmm. I decided to do an art piece every day.
So it just kind of started as like a way to kill time?
Yeah, just something to look forward to after work too. Like I really got into it right away.
Okay.
And I was like, oh, what am I going to do tonight? You know,
mm-hmm.
You know, and pick up something right on the way from home that day. Like, I'm going to do something on this. And then I do it. This piece is called Help Me From My Pizza. This is a self-portrait of me. I would be both of these people. This is Sitting Bull. It's a recognizable image. It's an iconic image of him. Known as a very stubborn chief. Does not give in. And stands firmly on anything he believes in. And in this instance, it's like me in my pizza. You know? Like, it's almost a sickness. Like, I'm 40. I have high cholesterol. The doctors are like, "Hey man, you can't do this forever." And there's a stubbornness there, and I just can't. I have no willpower. And so this is myself restraining myself from the pizza. And the pattern on the sweatshirt is kind of like the mania of it, like the addiction in my head.
For our aspiring artists, how long did it take for you to actually become established? I know that varies with everybody, but
yeah, I didn't have to dive right into it. Like I wasn't like, man, I gotta like make a living off of this or something, because I was already, I was just about to go into, I got a job with a band out of Nashville and was gonna be hitting the road for most of the time, and I was on the road for most of the year,
mm-hmm.
playing drums and traveling the world. And so whenever I came home, I had money and didn't have to go back to work. So then I just go back to making art all the time. I book myself an art show at a music venue because I knew how to book my band at a venue.
Mm-hmm.
I've been doing that for years. So I booked all three of the bands I was playing with in Chicago before I had to quit those bands as kind of a last hurrah. And upstairs from the music venue, I had an art show and I had 28 pieces. and I didn't know what was going to happen. I just showed him and I put some price on it, and I sold over half of the stuff I had.
Yeah, that's
not,
nice.
Not just to friends that wanted to support me, but strangers that were there too.
Yeah, they just kind of dug your aesthetic.
Yeah, and that was inspiring. I was like, damn, I'm going to do more of this.
Yeah.
Yeah. But over about 5 years of touring and coming home and producing art, I started to put it out in different venues in the city,
mm-hmm.
and things started to sell more and more.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
This whole like layering, did that start from the start, or just as, you know, as
well,
it was like
just kind of like a one color stencil thing, you know, one color illustration on an object, and it wasn't until I discovered glass and started bringing glass home,
because mm-hmm.
there was tons of it in the alley, and people just throwing out a piece of tempered glass from like a TV unit, or I would find stacks of these windows and neighborhoods were being renovated. But I was thinking, okay, if I do one color there, it's opaque, I can just do something right over it if I'm going from the back.
Mm-hmm.
And I started layering things, just like putting shapes on there and then turning it and painting again, and you know, very simple.
So as far as like concepts and ideas go, mm-hmm. is that just how do you handle that process?
I don't put too much thought into it. I might have a neato idea that really I have to compose it, or it could just be an object that I really dig,
mm-hmm.
or a thing that I just want to make kind of an icon and put pretty things around it.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't put, there's not a whole lot of depth into it, and I know I talked today about doing a political piece, but I'm not even that politically fueled. It's just, I was driven by a thought.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it was a fun idea that I want to
capture.
I want to make it happen, yeah. Hey, this is another conflict piece. This is called A Civil War, actually. This is a conflict within my own house. This is me. I take from the butter wherever I damn well please. And my wife is like, no, you gotta take it from right here. And she gets really mad if I scoop the butter and make a big mess out of it. I actually made it for a Civil War themed art show.
Is that why you had that spoon tattoo?
Why?
Because same situation?
Yeah, I just like flatware. I have to eat, so.